Hello, friends, and welcome back to Stories About Entitled People. Let's start our video with the perfect and petty story with very minimal effort for maximum impact. But before we begin, don't forget to subscribe to our channel if you're new here, and turn on notifications so you don't miss a new video every single day. Here we go. Karen gets schooled. A long time ago, I worked in a pub. Not a fancy place. The kind of place where your uniform is a green golf shirt and you have a change belt around your waist. A lot of pitchers of beer and sticky floors, etc. Anyway, I'd already quit. It was a great place to work. I was just moving for school and had done my last shift, but picked one up for a friend. A group of people around my age, but a couple years younger, which is a thing when you're in your early and mid-20s, came in. They seemed to be slumming it. And there was one girl who was obviously quite well off and demanding the entire attention of the group the entire time. She kept snapping her fingers to get my attention and being generally obnoxious. Acting like an obnoxious high roller who was racking up a five-figure bill, which was pretty ludicrous when the most expensive item on the menu was a burger that, if you finished the whole thing, was free. She made a couple unreasonable demands and was generally rude and dehumanizing to me. Her friend seemed embarrassed. They were finally wrapping up and paying their bill, and she pushes a tip across the table at me, and I pushed it back at her and said, in front of the whole table, "I don't want your money." She got very flustered and pushed the money back and said, "It's my tip, you have to take it." And I said, "No, I don't. But I have a tip for you. Don't be rude to someone who's going to be alone with your lunch." And then I added a cheery, "Enjoy your day," and left. The beautiful thing is, I didn't do anything to her food, nor would I ever have. But she doesn't know that. To this day, she'll be wondering what I did to the food she ate. I really hope she learned a lesson. Hard to say. And our second story. Whatever chainsaw I want, you say? This is not my story, but of a friendly, vindictive old man who I'll call Fred that I worked with for around 5 months. I, 18-year-old male, do tree work for a living and have for around 2 years now. My boss, who I'll call Duncan, is a 32-year-old hotshot and the owner of our small company, who can sometimes be a real tool when things aren't going fast enough on a job. Now, Duncan has an old family friend named Fred. Fred worked with Duncan's stepfather at a cement plant for 20 years and his stepfather's best friend. Fred also retired from said cement plant. Fred is the kind of man who would give you the shirt off his back while being an absolute vindictive smartass about you not having a shirt. However, Fred was working for Duncan as a favor, since Duncan was understaffed at the time. Because of this, Fred couldn't give a flying F about his job or what Duncan said or did. Fred took as many breaks as he wanted, when he wanted, and wouldn't hesitate to tell you where to stick your opinion if you said something about it. Fred is also a complete bull of a man who stands at a hearty 6'3 and 275 and easily makes Duncan, 5'10 and 160, look like a shrimp. So usually Duncan isn't too quick to bother him. So one day we're all doing our own thing on the job. We had a big old pin oak to take down, so we're all in our usual positions, Jake up in the bucket truck, James running our loader, and Fred and I chipping brush and shooting the breeze. Although I admit we were slightly slacking off. Duncan decided he was going to sharpen all the chainsaws that were not currently in use, so he gets to work. Now, for those of you who don't know, sharpening a saw takes a while, and on top of that, all of our saws were extremely dull, so they took a lot of sharpening in 95-degree heat while being stooped down on the door of one of the boxes on our bucket truck. Duncan was sharpening saws for the better part of 2 hours, 8 saws. When he finished, we had the vast majority of the tree cut down, all the branches were off, and Fred and I had long since shut down the chipper and were taking our lunch since we had nothing to do as wood is being moved from the ground to the dump trailer by James and the loader. For some reason, the fact that we had 20 minutes more work infuriated Duncan. This is especially odd because the tree was coming down very quickly compared to usual, as it was Friday and we were all hoping to cut off early as we sometimes did. Duncan flew off the handle, screaming at us for the better part of 10 minutes, which ironically extended us to 30 minutes more on the job rather than 20, and he ended his tirade with, "I'm leaving to go do estimates, finish and go cut firewood at the yard. You will not be cutting off a second before 3:30. As Duncan stormed away, Fred piped up from the back of the group, just as sweet as pie with anticipation dripping from his voice, "Hey, lipstick, which saw do you want us to use?" To which Duncan replied, "I don't give a F," and stormed away. Me and Fred smiled at each other, thinking the same thing. When we arrived back at the yard, we began getting saws off the truck, from the smallest of trim saws to the largest brand spanking new steel MS-881 Magnum with a 42-inch bar that we used to cut particularly large stubs. Me and Fred both grabbed a saw and fired them up. We began to cut and cut and cut and cut. For almost 3 hours we cut firewood, making sure to hit the dirt with the saws as much as possible, and going through every saw until they were almost unusable from how dull they were. Trust me, if anyone knows how to dull a saw quick, it's a tree professional. Fred and I were having the time of our lives, dancing and singing and cracking jokes while we cut, while screaming to be heard over the painful wailing of saws being tortured. When 3:30 rolled around, we threw the saws back in the truck and went home. And I still swear to this day that I heard Fred singing at the top of his lungs as he rolled out of the lane in a cloud of black smoke, which may have been his crankshaft eating some gaskets. Monday, when we got to work, we rolled out to the job site, and Duncan fired up the mammoth steel to crush a huge hickory tree in the middle of the woods. He began to cut, or should I say, grind the tree. The wood was smoking from the terrible amount of friction from a saw that was as dull as it could get. Duncan stopped, he checked the chain, he got another saw and checked the chain, dull. He went through every saw and checked the chains, getting redder and redder. He walked over to me and Fred. "Fred, OP, why is every saw dull?" To which Fred responded, "Well, Duncan, you told us you don't give a F which saw we used, so we used them all. That shouldn't be an issue, right? Since you don't give a F." To which Duncan sighed, knowing exactly what we did, and walked off to sharpen all of the saws again. Fred is and always will be my hero and my best friend. He's currently back to living the retired life of working on cars and fishing. Many days I miss him and his offhanded comments, but I'm carrying on his legacy of smartassery. Disclaimer, Duncan is not a bad boss at all. In fact, he's the best boss I've ever had. He just has the mindset that time is money and that some things should go faster than they possibly ever could. For some reason, it never occurred to me that chainsaws have to be sharpened. And our next story. Entitled mother thinks she owns my house. Characters: EM, entitled mother, EK, entitled mother's kid, OP, me, GF, my girlfriend. Background: I live in a rather quiet apartment building, but as soon as this crazy bee moved here, I knew that my situation was going to go boobs up. I always try my best to be kind to my neighbors, and it wasn't any different for EM. I enjoy having small get-togethers in my apartment with a couple of my neighbors, so when EM and her annoying as hell kid moved into the building, I decided to invite them to a weekly Friday adults-only game night. Don't judge me, this was all pre-COVID. The party was set to begin at 7 o'clock, but EM came a good hour late. Our parties are adults-only because we have lots of alcoholic beverages and some weed set out. EM decides to ignore the clear-as-day rule that kids aren't allowed, and she decides to bring her little craphead to my house. As soon as I see the kid, I tell her no kids allowed, but she goes and says, "It's okay, he has my permission." I sigh and ask her to come back in 10 minutes. Now, me and the neighbors have to clear all the cigarette and alcohol and pack them in the cupboards. She and her kid come back in 30 minutes and immediately start eating all of my food. I'm a really non-confrontational person, so telling them to stop was a big no-no. This isn't even the real story yet, it's just some background to explain the crap show that's about to happen. The story. COVID happened, my girlfriend was staying at my place during COVID because her parents both have pre-existing conditions. We went through the whole process, quarantine, testing, and eventual moving. So one day, I was out of the house getting my groceries when my girlfriend called me crying and saying she didn't feel safe in our apartment. Apparently, my girlfriend was taking a shower when she heard someone. She thought it was me, and she opened the curtain to see EK. That little effer was peeking at her and standing outside the open bathroom door. She screamed and kicked him out. Hearing this, I immediately rushed home to comfort her, having absolutely no clue how that little bee turd got into my home. As soon as I get home, I see entitled mother standing outside my apartment, banging on the door, maskless. I tap her on the shoulder and start to explain to her that she really needs to control her kid. I tried to be as nice as possible, even though I was seething with anger. I tried to tell her that breaking into people's houses and doing crap like this wasn't okay at all. Before I can finish, EM goes off at me. She starts screaming that her son didn't break into anyone's house and that my girlfriend had no right to hit him. She said she was going to call the cops and tell them we assaulted the little crap. Even though at this point I'm literally about to slap her, I try my best to remain calm and ask her how her mistake of a son got into my house. The entitled mother starts screaming at me, and in her anger, she lets slip that during my neighborly meeting, in the background section, she took one of my apartment's keys. My brain just shuts off. Girlfriend comes out, hearing the commotion, and apparently heard that EM stole my keys. Girlfriend goes off. Says she's calling the cops for stealing, breaking, and entering, and invasion of privacy. At this point, my brain is still processing what entitled mom just said, and she screams back that in her rental agreement, she was given access to all the amenities of the apartment, and she somehow believed that my house belonged to them too. Keep in mind, I own my apartment. My girlfriend and I kept strong on her promise and called the cops right then and there. Entitled mom got arrested, but I don't know what happened from there. All I know is that I changed my locks, got only two new house keys, gave one to girlfriend and kept one, and bought one of those camera doorbell things. Good on you for calling the cops. That is just not acceptable behavior from anyone. Hey guys, thank you all for watching the video. I'll see you in the next one.